Hello everyone, my name is JSRP and you're watching Kalakar Makerspace videos. In today's Friday project video, we're going to see how we can make lights like this. It's pretty simple. We are going to use these aluminum profiles that goes inside concealed ceilings or POP. We're going to cut them in different shapes and try to make LEDs like this. It is a totally DIY project, so I hope you stick around till the end and watch this video. These are called as profile putties and they are actually made of aluminium. They come in various thickness. This is 1.2 and you get it in 0.8 as well. We usually go with 1.2 because the aluminium not only acts as a profile which goes inside the ceiling, but it also dissipates the heat that is generated by the LEDs. And that's why it is required that you use a very good material of aluminium. So they come in different sizes. This is 30mm width, this is 20mm width. They come actually with the diffusers here. These diffusers are usually white in color, so that depending upon the LED that you put, like yellow, red, this diffuser will help not show the hot spots. So this is a 20mm one. We also have a really thin one. This is just 10mm. I really like this one because it's very sleek and just fits everywhere. But of course, for this we have to buy a special LED which has a width of 5mm, because this is 10mm, we can put only 5mm width LEDs inside this. This is a 15mm one, very standard one, and we use this almost everywhere. This comes with a deep of around 10mm. The more the depth, the more the diffusion happens. If you see this, this has a depth of only 5mm and the diffusion is actually less. So this is good for 240 or 120 LEDs. By 240 or 120 I mean per meter. But the most common ones are this 15mm by 10mm depth ones. Before cutting the aluminum profiles, we have to prep it. I'm using masking tape here to tighten up the diffuser and the aluminum profile so that when we cut it, it doesn't blow on the face. Also, the masking tape acts as a place where I can mark with the pen. This is a very important step and we cannot skip this, even if you're cutting with the handsaw or the miter saw. It just gives clean cut. I'm using an aluminum cutting blade on the miter saw and I'm going very slow in the cutting so that it just doesn't blow up on the face. Again, I'm using the blow up on the face metaphor because that literally happens. Once the pieces are cut, you get the shape here. The miter saw was set at 60 degrees because I'm going to make a hexagon. If you're going to make an octagon, then it is 30 degrees. I cut all the pieces really slow and then assemble it together. Here are all the pieces cut and ready. Now I can just put it on the table and see how big the size comes up to. This will also give me an idea on where to put the joints. And here I'm using bond or cyanoacrylate with foam pieces to join the two pieces. You can actually get clips also for this purpose, but because this is a DIY video, I went totally with what I had at the shop. Make sure to align the pieces correctly and then I glued the pieces together, and just a lot of pressure on the foam helps it secure. You'll be surprised how well bond works with foam and aluminium. And here the hexagon is totally done and you can see all the joints are seamless and really perfect. This is only because I cut the aluminum pieces really slow in the miter saw. Because the foam sheet were protruding a little out, I had to go ahead and trim it off. To do that, you can just use a knife or utility knife and just shave it off. It just comes out like a cream, so there's not much effort. You can do it freehand. I made sure to give a good shape to this foam sheets. Just make sure that you don't remove excess material in the foam sheet. You can also use 3mm material, but I used 5mm material and then shaved off the excess according to my requirement. This is 120 LEDs per meter strip. This was lying around because it has lost its adhesiveness at the back, I'm going to use cyan acrylate here. This is a daylight LED, which means it is around 4000 Kelvin. Bond actually works well with a lot of materials, given a few exceptions. In this case, it works really well with the LEDs and the aluminium. I have seen people join two aluminium pieces also with bond. Because these aluminium profiles are anodized, there's some kind of a chemical coating on the top, and when you attach any piece to the aluminium extrusions, it works out well. Because this aluminium profile is 30 mm in width, I can actually double up the LEDs. Doubling up is going to do two things. One, it is going to give too much of brightness. At the same time, yes, it will heat up a lot, and that's why you need a bigger profile like this. After doubling up the LEDs, this is how it looks. And we can go ahead and solder the wires and put the power supply. For the power supply, I'm using this sleek power supply. It is 12 volts at 5 amperes. For this number of LEDs, 5 amperes is better. For 1 meter, we will actually use around 2 amperes. And since this is 2 rounds of LEDs, a 5 ampere power supply is good enough. Let's go ahead and test it. Wow, that's too bright. Too bright for the need, but that's only because you are at a very close proximity. If I hang it, it's going to be fine. To hang these LED lights, I'm going to drill some pilot holes using 2mm drill bit. When I pasted the LEDs, I was careful enough to side them up to one corner so that when I drill it, it is perfectly fine. These are some J-hooks that I'm going to use. These are the smaller ones. The good thing about using profile lights is they are very, very light even with the power supply. So if I use this tiny hooks to hang the lights from the ceiling, still they will not put any stress on the structure of the profile light. These are galvanized braided wire with rubber coating on the top. I chose this one because the rubber coating gives life to the galvanized steel, and of course it doesn't let it rust. There is another option where we can use black wires. If that is your taste, you can get them from the hardware shop. But I went with the clear coating on the galvanized steel. To secure it, again, we can get aluminium clips that you just have to wound on the top and then crush it with the pliers. But because this is a DIY video, I went ahead with the zip ties. I used double zip tie because it shouldn't slip and fall on somebody's head. Once all the three sides are done, you can go ahead and hang it from the ceiling. I just put a hook on the top, and using some binding wires, we made a structure where I can just hook this LED light. Let's go ahead and see how beautiful it looks. The LED that you saw being made in this video was a hexagon shape, but you can actually make triangle shapes, you can make squares, you can make an octagon. There's just any number of geometric shapes that you can make. The principle is just the same. Make sure that you find the angle that you want to cut it in, cut it, joint it with foam or the clips, and then you're good to go. And once you make mini lights like this and then you arrange it in a pattern, it just becomes really beautiful. Now you don't have to go ahead and buy all those expensive chandeliers. Now you can make lights on your own for your home. There are a few tips that you need to remember, that when you cut the aluminium profiles, make sure that you use a handsaw, or if you're going to use a miter saw, then run it very, very slow. Let the blade do the cutting. That's more important, otherwise it will just hit on your face. Secondly, When you cut the aluminum profiles, cut along with the diffuser so that the measurements remain the same and you don't have issues later when you're assembling the pieces together. Recently, I've been trying to work with tube lights. The reason that I like tube lights better than these LEDs are because these LEDs require a 12 volt power supply, which is an additional cost. Whereas when you buy a tube light, it already has a power supply and it is included inside. Let's discuss about that in a future video, but for now, thank you for sticking till the end of this video. Please follow me on Instagram and please post your questions on Instagram and YouTube comments so that I check them regularly. I upload a Q&A video every month, so I will definitely answer your questions over there. Hope I see you in the next vlog or a Friday project video. Until next time, happy learning.